While we're on the Mesa, Aztecs Nation remains on high alert, waiting for Interim President Sally Rausch to rule on the University Senate's recommendation to transition away from the Aztec mascot. Back in November, the University Senate, consisting of faculty, staff, administrators, and at least one coach, voted 52-15 to retire the human depiction of the Aztec warrior. It's a non-binding resolution now on the desk of Ms. Rausch. Well, I'll tell you what, I know at least one person who's pretty darn interested. I'm joined now by a man who needs no introduction, at least as far as Aztec Nation is concerned, a former Monty Montezuma and now a real estate mogul here in San Diego, Carlos Gutierrez. Carlos, long time no chat.
Great to see you.
Let's stipulate this cause is near and dear to your heart. Just as a quick background, you were Monty Montezuma. You're the quintessential Monty Montezuma for most people's eyes. 90 to 98, you did it?
As the original Monty.
That's your alter ego. Talk about it a little bit.
Completely. So I had the opportunity to basically represent San Diego State. And when I had that opportunity, I really saw that this was much bigger than myself and the university and the community and then the nation. I mean, they were on, you know, ESPN on kind of a weekly basis back at that time.
And you did it for well past what would be a school career. I mean, and you did it for 9, 10 years, right?
I made it a career.
So when did the blowback about the Aztec warrior slash Monty Montezuma, was that happening when you were doing it?
It was Monty Montezuma, and then I retired in 98, and then in 2000 is when that whole thing really erupted, and then Dr. Weber went behind closed doors, killed Monty Montezuma, and brought out his ambassador Montezuma. So a small group of alumni, four friends of ours, they put the Aztec Warrior Foundation together, and then they had me play the role. So 2002, we came out. I went to 60 events a year, and not only football games or basketball games. I did parades. I spoke at schools. I did charity events. And that's what I believe that SDSU should be doing a little bit more. Nevertheless, the vote went 2003. It was the Aztec Athletic Foundation alumni, paying alumni, and the students. Largest voter turnout in the history. It was 89 or 90%. They wanted the human mascot, the Aztec warrior, to be the role in the new uniform.
And now you're kind of at it again with the latest petition drive. Competing petition drives. Yours is doing very well. Tell people how they, if they want to get stick their beak in, how they can get involved.
So really what you're going to be putting it on the site here, change.org, and then it's on my Facebook, Carlos Gutierrez, or on my Instagram, Carlos Nonstop. And you can do it that way. But really, I think call Sally Rausch, call her, email her, let her know what you feel and what you think.
We'll get to that in a second. So it's now on her desk. What's the timeline? What happens next?
You know, I really don't even know. I haven't talked to Sally, and I'm really here just as a fan, as a San Diego native and a Mexican and a representative of SDSU for many, many years.
Has anyone price tagged? I mean, it's a branding thing. Man, for a school that's supposedly financially strapped, to change, does anyone calculate how much that would cost?
Unfortunately, this other group that it's opposing, it's 11 people. I don't know if they're all students. I know Ozzy's not a student either. They don't really care. It's just about them. It's really a little political grandstanding, and it's basically just about their feelings about what's going on. But it's going to be in the hundreds of millions of dollars, basically. The loss of alumni donations, which this other group says that the money, if they stopped it, would not be much. They're crazy.
All right, so let's give me
a lot.
I didn't want to throw up her phone number because I don't want to do that. Yeah. But let's. This is how to contact Sally Rausch if you have.
Civil.
I mean, we're
completely. This is not to be complaining and things like that. It's really letting them know that you're an Aztec. You love it. Why you love it? We're so close to Mexico. So here's my thing: I've got friends that are on the tribes here in San Diego, and I asked them, because they're very close. I grew up with them. Going, what do you think about this? And not like saying, hey, they know who I am and what I do, and I want to know honestly. And they're going, like, why should we wipe out this name, the Aztecs? Because so many other native names have been wiped out. So why should we wipe out the Aztecs name from the planet of San Diego?
I can answer that question. If there's a group of people who feel, whether you accept it or not, that feel it's a racial slur of sorts.
Completely, yep.
Well, the cool thing about our country is that it's not just majority rule.
Exactly.
That we listen to the minority has rights and their voice can be heard.
Good.
So if a group of people say, hey, this insults me, this offends me, why should we they continue to be assaulted and offended?
All right, well, you know what? I'd say, hey, I understand. I don't have to agree with what you're saying. And if you don't like it, you can maybe change and go to a different university. If you do actually, you're an Aztec and you're a student there, other than just saying that, hey, I'm going to be a political grandstander and I'm going to get on my soapbox and basically say, hey, you know what? I don't like this. And you know what? I say it's a democracy, right? I say put it to a vote again if that's going to happen. In 2003, 90%. Granted, I think the country's got a little softer in that sense of people being offended
still,
so easily.
Say it's 80% now. It's still
overwhelming. All right,
so
completely.
You were talking about, help me out here, about scholarships, about educating people, going to Mexico City and learning about the Aztec warriors. Talk a little bit about that.
So I asked my wife if we could do this, because I did this in 95. I went down with my friend Joel Zwink, and we were on the ruins of the Temple of the Sun, and we went throughout Tenochtitlan, and we went to Zocalo, and we went to the museums, and unfortunately, I didn't really get to go to the universities at that time because it was all me, and I really did it pretty quickly. Nevertheless, we would like to create a scholarship for SDSU, and I would like to go personally with the new warriors and take them down to educate them about Mexico and
so
about
your successors.
The
you would take them one on.
Completely, and that's one thing that SDSU hasn't done. They don't have really somebody teaching the new warriors and educating them of exactly what's going on, in which I believe they could educate so many more people. And that's one thing that I believe that the Native Americans are upset with, that they were not promoting the native, the Kumeyaays, or promoting the native traditions and things like that. That's one of the things that they're upset with. So I say, hey, San Diego State, let's step up, put a little bit of money into it, give free education. You do an online course and basically educate people about the native lands here, about the Aztecs, about all about North America. I think it'd be amazing. They could really come out on top on this.
Before you go, can I ask a real estate question?
Please do, yes.
I mean, being that you are a real estate mogul?
Yes.
That new tax bill might take away home mortgage deductions. Here in California, that would be a killer. What's that going to do to your business?
Let's see what happens when it happens, and we'll find out.
2018, good year in real estate?
I think it's going to be a great year. I think, you know, we got a shortage of inventory. We got a lot of baby boomers moving on. We got a lot of millennials moving up, or, you know, interest rates are low. Hey, the American dream is to own a home, and, you know, the economy's good. So I'd say buy, sell, whatever's going to work for you. I can help
you. That's an all-service sportscast. Not only do you get the Aztec debate, but you also get a little real estate mixed in. On behalf of Carlos Gutierrez, my name is Rudy. We're done for now. We'll see you in the 6 o'clock newscast right after these short but important commercial words.
See you later.